Good day, grade 7. It's another week and it's another lesson to be discussed and be tackled. And before anything, before we move on to our lesson today, let's have a quick review regarding our past lessons. So in our past lessons, we define or we gave the examples of media. So we have the print media, the broadcasting media, the outdoor media, and then the internet. So today, or this week, we go deeper the specific difference between print media to broadcasting media. So here, the difference between print and broadcast news is that broadcast news is written for listeners and viewers turning in with their ears and sometimes their eyes. Diba? We define broadcasting media as we perceive it by our own, by our two senses, which is the hearing and then our sight. And broadcasting news, such as in television and in radio, not unlike the print media, it is a tangible information structure to be read. When we say tangible information, it can be perceived through our sense of touch, yung nahahawakan natin siya. Kaya nga siya print media, because we can hold it and we can reread it every time. Print news uses AP styles, while broadcast news uses AP style as well as a broadcast presentation style. With print and news, the concern is in newspaper space and sentences are between 20 to 25 words. Usually kasi, sa print media kasi minamaximize natin yung spacing dun kapag nagpiprint tayo. It's either magazine or newspaper, not unlike sa broadcast media. Diba, naririnig lang natin siya. So therefore, we cannot, yung minamaximize lang natin is that in how you deliver it, the proper delivery, the correct information to be delivered. So yun lang yung concern natin. So print media, you need to concern the spacing, the writing styles, and of course, the wordings. Also, in broadcast media, you need to consider the words that you need to be used. Kasi syempre may mga taong hindi naman nakakaintindi ng mas malalim na English, ayan, kagaya ng sa print media, sa news. Kasi you need to be specific, you don't use flowery words in news, ayan po. So hindi po tayo gumagamit ng ganong mga bagay kapag nagsusulat po. You need to be specific and it to be, your words had to be low-key in order for your readers to relate of what you are saying, what you have been telling them, in order for them to grasp the information needed. So yun po yung sa my news. Ayan. With broadcast news, the length of time is a concern. Stories being structured for multitasking consumers, sentences are 10 to 15 words, and present tense is always used. Why? We always use present tense because in news we need to be recent, and the news should be current. Ibig sabihin nangyayari siya ngayon. Hindi siya matatawag. Although it's news, it's still news, but in the past. But what is more important is that we are very vigilant of what is happening around us. Therefore, information or news should be current or recent. Print news uses inverted pyramid. Pag sinabi natin inverted pyramid, yung tuktok po ng pyramid ng triangle is nasa baba. Kasi parang nangyayari po sa inverted pyramid is that the most important details hanggang sa least important details, yun po yung yung structure ng news, 'di ba? Yung katawan niya po, yung sa base niya po, yung nasa taas is then yung tuktok niya po, yung pointed is in nasa baba, because you need to write the most important details up until to the lower part of the news or the content, which is the least important, from most important to least important. Ayan po, especially Kasi syempre yung iba hindi naman ganun ka-vivid or ka mapagbasa. So therefore, usually yung inuna nila is yung nasa unahan lang. Therefore, yung lalagay lang dapat sa news is yung sa unang part ng news or sa first paragraph is the most important details that needed for us na ito yung information na kailangan ko lang. So therefore, doon pa lang sa una. Okay, there are also differences in the specific organizational patterns in broadcast and print news. Print news uses inverted pyramid, which puts the most important details at the top and least important details are built from the lead sentence. In broadcast, this dramatic unity is similar to inverted pyramid, but it is different. Dramatic unity uses a lead in followed by a climax, cause, and effect. So these are the structures in writing a news. This model is much more simplified than print. Kasi syempre, yun nga lang yung ma-maximize mo yung time sa broadcast. Not unlike sa print media, you are spacing, the sentence structure, yung tama, at yung hindi tamang ilagay doon. So, yun po yung uses the difference of print news to broadcast news. Okay po. And then, usually po kasi sa print news, much convenient na po ang broadcast news kasi kahit saan naman napapanood natin, nababalikan natin yung mga balita, di ba, na meron na tayong live, yan, napapanood natin sa FB, yan, very ano na ngayon, very easy access na tayo ngayon when it comes to grasping information from internet, from print media, no? Mas convenient na ngayon na dahil hawak-hawak natin, di ba? You are in advanced technology world, whereas where technology very advanced, very prominent, and very rampant regarding in using, di ba? Kahit nga bata, nakakapag gamit ng technology. So, easy access na ngayon yung mga ganyang bagay. Even, ano ngayon, print media, usual na, ngayon nga wala na akong masyadong nakikita yung nagproproduce ng dyaryo. But, during high school, dun sa isang shop namin, maraming nagbibenta ng mga dyaryo. Pero ngayon, hindi ko na nakikita masyado yung dyaryo. Kasi, like, may na-bulletin in the Philippines, so you can access them through internet. You can read them through internet. Search mo lang sa yung kanilang mismong website. Then you can look for or find the specific information that you needed in the specific activity. In reference to leads, print news leads are robust and answer many of the W's, yung who, what, when, where, why, and how. In regards to news, broadcast leads use fewer words, use contraction, ayan. Kasi nga, sabi ko nga sa inyo, minamaximize nila yung time. Therefore, hindi pwede siya yung pakahaba-habang sinasabi. You need to be brief, but although it is brief, all the information is there. Or the informations are there. So, yun yung minamaximize ng broadcast media. And engage the audience. They also have two other styles of leads. Nevertheless, broadcast news is criticized for exaggerating news and simplifying news stories to where the stories can be distorted by viewers. Ayan. They are also criticized for creating stories based on the bias of company or company's owner. Yes, very good. Usually, ang journalist is dapat wala kang kinikilingan. You should not be biased. Pag sinabi natin biased, meron ka pinapanikan. That's the sense of the news. You should not be biased. Even in print media, you should not be biased. Kasi syempre, you are delivering information to the viewers or to the listeners. You should not be, you should be vigilant in choosing sides. Much better, don't choose any sides. Just your main concern is to give information, needed information important information for the viewers or for the audience. So now, your activity is to create your own medium in order for the readers to know the difference, specific difference, or the clear differences between media and print media to broadcast media. So you can use two platforms, either digital brochure or poster, the infographics po yan. Infographics, ayan po. And then the poster making. Sa poster making, also the paper po. And then sa infographics, the difference between infographics and also the paper is that electronics pong infographics. Kailangan nyo po siya through internet or through editing apps. Marirecommend ko po sa inyo is Canva. Ayan, Canva. Pwede kayo po mag-edit po dun. Yun. And then, poster. Of course, poster. You can draw your difference between broadcast and print media in poster making in Oslo paper. You can use that. Ayan. So, ito po yung example ng infographics. Ayan po. Ito po yung example. Yung kagandahan ng electronic poster making is that mas clear, hindi mo na kailangan mag-drawing, mas clear yung message, and then napapractice or nahahasa yung skills mo sa editing as well as yung sa computer. Pero kasi syempre, hindi naman lahat merong computer, merong source of internet. Therefore, you can use poster making. Kaya dalawa yung nilagay ko. Kasi I still consider those students that doesn't have internet, stable internet, and computers. Ayan po. So, pero kung infographics, at kung magaling naman kayo, meron naman kayong source of internet, why not using infographics, electronic infographics? So, ayan. So, ito po yung pwede nyo pong site. Mga free lang po mga to. Canva, Bundles Go, Edro, Photoshop, ayan. Even Microsoft Publisher, you can lay out your work. Save lang po kayo ng mga pictures and then pwede na po kayong, ano kasi yung mga ano naman po doon eh, may mga templates naman po na pwede nyo gamitin sa infographics nyo. And then poster making, of course, poster making. So, yan lang po ang ating lesson for today. And before I forget, our rubric in creating or you're in your work. Ayan, the cleanliness, of course, cleanliness, creativity, and content. Ngayon, paalala ko lang po, kailangan nyo pa rin pong magpasa po ng mga projects nyo po. Kasi kung wala po kang may pasa, wala din po ako mas gigrade sa inyo. Okay po? Good day and have a nice day.